got a friend in me. You've got a friend in me. When the road looks rough ahead and you're miles and miles from your nice warm bed, you just remember what your old past said. Boy, you got a friend in me. Yeah, you've got a friend in me.
To be able to help them bloom into a wonderful, adoptable animal is just a fabulous feeling. Whether it's a semi-feral kitty to a under-socialized dog who just needs lots of love and attention, and a lot of it, it's that. It's the attention and the love that they need and that we give them to help them succeed.
I am beautiful, no matter what they say.
And what's been sad this year is, as I mentioned, that we've had quite a few owner surrenders. With the economy the way it has been, these poor animals have had to lose a home that they've been in for maybe years and come to the shelter. And it's been kind of a hard adjustment for some of these animals.
When you take on an animal, you've made a commitment to that animal, and we like to think of for life. And when animals are abandoned, somebody has let them down. But I don't want us to let them down. So that's why it's so important to be able to get animals fixed and have the resources to care for the animals that we have, that we can find homes for and that we can take care of.
You found me.
We have little Columbus here. And I don't know if you can see, Columbus has a birth defect on that one of his front legs is not fully formed. Now, you know, our vet examined it and said, you know, it doesn't really need surgery. He is what he is. I have people that say, oh, that's really sad. But you know what? Columbus doesn't think it's sad because it doesn't slow him down a bit. And we're going to find a home. He was recently neutered, and he's available for adoption.
To find me.
Connection for me of going into the classroom with children and animals really has made my life fulfilled.
Dogs and cats are other animals. They also have feelings like we do.
So many animals that people don't want, they just get rid of them.
It's a wonderful thing because children are so appreciative and they love animals so much. So hopefully they will remember all the things that they've been taught and hand them on to their children.
I think Pets Lifeline has been done a great job in their community as being the leader in providing a resource, but the resource doesn't come without a cost, and unfortunately, donations are needed to be able to support an effort like this.
I think anybody who owns a pet ought to get it neutered. And some people can't afford that, so Pets Lifeline makes that possible.
There is no excuse for not spaying or neutering your animals when the price is $30.
So our top three goals for Pets Lifeline over the next 5 years, number one would have to be facility. To upgrade our facility so that we can better serve our animals medically and spiritually. Also the kids programs. Number two would have to be enhancing our children's programs. Our summer camp is fabulous, but we'd really like to have a solid after school program so the kids could come here every day and learn more about humane education. And number three would be our spay neuter program, to be able to provide that more often and hopefully for free, so that we could get more folks in that can spay and neuter their pets. So we look forward to being able to do that and provide those things for our community.
You've got a friend in me. You've got a friend in me.
our vet said that he would do a lot better if the leg was amputated, and it's true, he can run around. He's just a sweet kitty.
I lost almost all the members of my family already, and my husband was most recently, about 8 or 9 months ago, and my house was just so empty. And now that I have Dorian, I'm so happy.
You got a friend in me.